His three prayers. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sammasambuddhassa. Namo tassa bhagavato arahato sammasambuddhassa. Please have your seat. Yesterday we get three questions. Is the consciousness can see into the future? Does that mean our future is predetermined? So when you can see the future, now about this person, so you can see one instant after another, so what will be, how will you begin? So, and then finally, what you began, you can see like that. We cannot say it is predetermined. No, it is, you can see all through his existence and finally what he will become. So he can do that. And then, why body move, vibrate during meditation? How to handle the situation? So, no, our body is made up of four primary elements. So when the Tejo element, or any Vayo element is predominant, so it pushing, so you get vibrations or something like that. And then the best thing is to calm down your mind. Try to be peaceful, and then try to focus and relax your, relax your mind, calm it down, and then try to focus on the meditation object. So slowly it will move away. No? And then another question is, what is meant by world system? It just means the world. It's all right. No? You can take just the world. So I use the world system to say that the world gets into the solar system in the right way, and then it has like the sun and the moon, the rising, giving light, so everything becomes all right. So I call it the world system. And about the planetary system, galaxy, universe, so what are they, he asked. So these are the science findings actually. So not the group of planets are called planetary system, and then very large group, galaxy, and then the universe seem to contain all the solar system. So I think the best way is to look at the dictionary. So I used to look at the dictionary to know each other, meaning of each word. So now today we can go to the light. I think you have to. So we go to chapter 4 today about cognitive series. It is called Vitik in Pali. And then yesterday we finished the lifespan of consciousness. So what is the lifespan of consciousness? So we have down here. No, the life of a chitta is equal to three sub-moments of arising, existing, and perishing of the citta, or it is equal to one consciousness movement, or one citta khana. In Pali, we call citta khana. So just you have to know like that. And then about the lifespan of materiality, I think it is down here maybe. So the lifespan of materiality is not equal to 17 times the lifespan of consciousness. So the lifespan of material can be taken as equal to 70 consciousness movement, chaitakana. So 17 consciousness movement is, if you even multiply by 3, you get 51 sub-movements. Thus, rupa also arises and perishes. At the tremendous rate of more than 58 billion. So we see the chitta arise and perish 1,000 billion. Per snap of the hand. So if you divide that 1,000 billion with 17, then we get 58 billion times. So just to make it easy, I say it is per second. The difference between chitta and rupa is that chitta, consciousness, arises one after another, so only one at a time it arises. One after another continuously, whereas rupa arises by several units at a sub-moment. And it goes on arising incessantly at every sub-moment. Therefore, materiality, rupa, may be grouped together two large masses, which are visible to the naked eye, whereas the fleeting stream of consciousness is invisible to the naked eye. The genetic sub-movement and the perishing, the perishing instead of dissolving. Not only dissolving, it perishes and disappears. So the perishing sub-movement of materiality lasts for one sub-movement each. Just like consciousness. Consciousness, it takes one sub-moment for arising and one sub-moment for perishing, the same thing. So the existing moment of rupa, materiality, lasts for 51 minus 2 for the sub-moment, 49 sub-moment. So it can last quite a long time, 49 sub-moment. And now we see six types of consciousness. So we have seen that there are six types of sense door and six types of the vattu, etc. So they also made six types of consciousness. So the two-eye consciousness is called chakhu vijnana. Two-ear consciousness is called soda vijnana. Two-nose consciousness is called gana vijnana. Two-tongue consciousness is called jiva vijnana, and two body consciousness is kaya vijnana, and 79, the remaining. Now if you subtract 89, this 10, from 89, we get 79. These 79 consciousnesses, we call them mind consciousnesses, mano vijnana. Mano vijnana, directly, the translation, mind consciousness. So note that eye consciousness arises at the eye door depending on the eye base, chakhu vattu, and the same thing. The ear consciousness will arise in the ear door depending on the ear base. And the mind consciousness arises at the mind door depending on the heart base in the heart. So the heart base exists in the heart. And six types of cognitive series. So of the six types of consciousness, now we get six types of cognitive series. The cognitive series of consciousness is also divided into six classes, which may be named according to either to the six sense door or the six sense types of vijnana. Six types of this consciousness. So if you name according to the sense door, you just add viti, at the end of chakhu dwara. So we call chakhu dwara viti, Soda dwara viti, ghana dwara viti, jiva dwara viti, kaya dwara viti, and mano dwara viti. Or you can also call the name, so based on the six consciousnesses. Chakku vinyana, also just put viti. Chakku vinyana viti, soda vinyana viti, ghana vinyana viti, jiva vinyana viti, kaya vinyana viti, and mano vinyana viti. So, when the sense object appears in the idol, the idol cognitive series will arise. No, it's a series of consciousness that in order to be aware of the sense object. So when we go here, already the lifespan of materiality. So, which one? On the left, 109. So the causes for the arising of cognitive series. So four conditions must exist for the arising of idol cognitive series. And the idol, chakupasada, must be good. So now if you are blind, when a person is blind, the chakupasada may be absent in him, so he is blind. No? And the idol must be good. And then, the rupa ramana means visible object. No? Visible object must be present. Not only must be present, it must come in contact with the idol. Only then the eye consciousness will arise. As we have said, striking the match, remember? No? So the same thing. And then they say aloka, light must also be present. So if it is dark, we cannot see the object. And then also manodwara vachana, manasikara. No, attention must be present. So when they arise in one of the door, manasikara, must take notice of that sense object. We call apprehend the sense object. Only then we know the sense object. So similarly, four conditions are necessary for the arising of sota dwara viti. Sota pasada, ear door must be good. And then saddha ramana, sound is saddha ramana, must come in contact with this ear door. And then akasa, space, for the passing of sound must be present. So, if you live in a soundproof room, the sound cannot enter. So, you must have the space to come down to you. So, in science, we say, the sound, when we speak here, they make the vibration of the air. The air vibrates and then it comes into it strikes the eardrum, and the eardrum also vibrates in that motion. So, we know the sound like that. And now, the manasikara attention must be also present also. Four conditions must exist for the arising of ghana dwara viti, nose door, cognitive series. And then ghana basada, the nose door, must be good. And then gandha ramana, the smell is called gandha ramana, must be present and must come in contact with the door. And then vayo, air element that carries the smell must be present, and manasikara attention must be present. So when we say we open perfume bottle and put in front of us, if the air is blowing like that, the vapor cannot come in contact with the nose. So when there's no breeze like that, so the vapor, the air will carry it to come in contact with the nose, only then we know the smell. And then we have also four conditions for the arising of jiva dwara viti, tangdo cognitive series. Jiva basada, tangdo must be good. And rasa ramana, taste must be present and must come in contact with the tatangdo, and abhor liquid element such as saliva must be present, and also manasikara attention must be present. So why is abhor required? So when we chew the food, no, see the tongue, the jiva basada, no, jiva basada, the tongue do, no, is, you know, the below the surface of the tongue, below the surface of the tongue, no. So we chew the food, and then when it, you know, it becomes, you know, the then when it is chew, it can dissolve in saliva, and then can seep, no, through the tongue to get in, to get contact with the eye door, no, below the surface of the tongue. Only then we know the taste, and that's why we know the liquid, no, the saliva. And then four conditions must be present for the rising of kaya dwara, no, the body door, cognitive series. Kaya basada, body door must be present. So this kaya basada, it exists throughout our body. Where we touch, we know the touch. We have, no, the kaya basada below the skin. And then, no, puttabha ramana, the touch, or no, the touch must come in contact, no, with the body door. And then tadda patvi. No, tadda patvi mean firm solid element must be present. So must be present for transmittance of the touch. So remember, no, the patvi, the element of solidity, has the characteristics of softness and hardness. So that hardness is called, no, the solid here. So when only we had the solid one, when we make the touch, it is a push. So it can, no, it can be conveyed, the touch can be conveyed to be in contact and the kaya basada below the skin. No? Just like you have, no, the marbles in contact together, if you push this one, all will be moved. No? So the touch will be like carried like that. And then we have manasikara, attention must be present. Four conditions must be present for the arising of manodwara. We think mind door, cognitive series, mind door, manodwara must be present. Remember, what is a mind door? It is life continuum, buinga chitta, no, that arise in the heart, depending on the heart base. No? So when you get on the concentration, like jhana concentration, you can see, no, the mind door, no, in the heart, you can see it. It is like a bright star, no, there. And then dhamma ramana means mind object. Remember, all the six sense objects can appear in the mind door. So any sense object, no? So this mind object, no, they are very subtle, they cannot appear in the five sense door. They appear only in the mind door. So when they appear, no, or they come in contact with the mind door, no, or they appear in the mind door, then we can, no, we get this cognitive series. Hadyavatu, the heart base. No, the heart base. So this, when they are in contact, no, mano vinyana chitta, no. So will arise, so it needs the heart base to depend on for its arising. And manasikara, attention must be present. No? So we say among the four conditions, no, the three conditions are, no, we could understand. And why manasikara, attention, no, must be present. So, no, I give an illustration here. No, now a mother with a young baby. No, usually like in, no, in our country, the mother, and she keeps the baby, you know, no, she sleep, to let the baby sleep just beside her, and then she have to be conscious of, no, the baby. So the baby will urinate very often. So you know, he will wake up very, very often. When she wakes up, she touch the cloth that's wrapped around the chai. So if the cloth is sweat, what should she do? She have to get up. So now change the cloth, and then breastfeed the body the baby, and then let him sleep. Let the baby sleep. So she have to get up several times a night. So that means she didn't get, she lost sleep. She cannot sleep very well. So if she have to sleep like this for several days, then she needs a sound sleep. So sometimes she fell very, very soundly asleep, snoring. And then even very loud thunder, strikes. And even the house shakes when the thunder, the loud thunder strikes. She doesn't really wake up. So still snoring. But if the baby wakes up and just make a very soft sound, the mother will wake up. So if you are paying attention, you can be, you can be aware of even the slight sound. And that's why we say, the manasikara is present. As we said, if the sense object appears in one of the sense door, that manasikara, manasikara. So manasikara that is present in the five door directing consciousness, we call it. Panja dwara vachana. So we say panta is bodhva vachana. It is like rotating, trying to take note of the any sense object that arises in each door. So when the sense object arises in the eye, then that panja dwara vachana will apprehend this sense object. So when we say it apprehends the sense object, it is manasikara. It is a chirasika manasikara that is present in the panja dwara vachana that takes notice of the sense object. That's why we say that manasikara is in the, must be present. If it does not take notice, then we do not know it. We don't know it. So the sense object can appear at the same time, but it can take notice of only one at a time. Not that panja dwara vachana. So we can know only one at a time. Now we go to the next now. Six types of presentation of sense objects at the five sense door. So now this presentation of sense objects is called DAY7PART1. DAY7PART1. So DAY7PART1 means presentation of sense objects at the sense door. There are six types of DAY7PART1. Four at the five sense door and two at the mind door. So the four presentations of the sense object at the five sense door. So one is Ati Mahanta Ramana. Mahanta means great. Ati means very. So it means very great intensity. So Aramana is the sense object. So for the five sense door we say, five sense object can appear in this five sense door. So those five sense objects with very great intensity. So, of course, when they appear in the eye door, though they cause a very long cognitive series of consciousness to arise. Mahanta Ramana, so we just remain ati, not the very. So we say five sense objects with fairly great. So they are less intense than the Ati Mahanta. So fairly great intensity. So when they appear in the sense of in the sense door, they cause a fairly long, not as long as here. It is very long, he has fairly long cognitive series of consciousness to arise. Prajna means slight. So prajna ramana means slight intensity. So when five sense object with slight intensity, they appear in the five door, they cause a short cognitive series of consciousness to arise. Ati prita ramana, very slight intensity. So when very slight intensity appears in the sense door, no, appears in the sense door. Very slight intensity, they cause no cognitive series to arise. So, and this is very important. No, this is very important. So we say, note, ati mahanda ramana, no, the very great intensity, sense object. No, it takes one consciousness moment to be distinct at the sense door after striking the door. So for mahanda ramana, it takes 2 to 3 consciousness moments. And then for Prita Ramana, it takes 4 to 9 conscious movement. And for Ati Prita Ramana, it takes 10 to 15 consciousness movement to become distinct at the sense door after striking the door. So remember, these 5 sense doors are materiality. 5 sense objects are also materiality. So now when this materiality, not strike the door, so we have chemical reaction. No chemical reaction. So no, you see, to appear the white color, the black color, the blue color. So you get that we need that chemical reaction. So it takes some time for them to appear. No, for the whole picture to appear. No. Now we can differentiate the 4 types. If it's ati bhanda ramana. No, after striking the sense door, it will become distinct. No, the sense object will become distinct in the eye door after one conscious movement. Just after one conscious movement. So one conscious movement is very short. Remember, 1,000 billion. So if you divide it into 1,000 billion time, the time would be very short. No? So for us, we say, it appears instantly, we think. No? But it takes that just one conscious movement. If it's ati mahanda ramana, no? So after it strikes the eye door, it takes 2 to 3 conscious movement to become distinct. And then if it's a prita ramana, it takes 4 to 9 conscious movement. And then for prita ramana, it takes 10 to 15 conscious movement for the sense object to become distinct. So we can differentiate them in this way. Now, if the sense object of the striking, it appears after one conscious movement, then we say it is ati mahanda ramana. And if it cannot arise, it does not become distinct after one conscious movement, then you know it is not ati mahanda ramana. So it become distinct after 2 conscious movement, then we say mahanda ramana. And also if it is weaker, it takes 3 conscious movement to become distinct, then also mahanda ramana. And if it cannot become distinct even after 3 conscious movement, then it is not mahanda ramana. So it can appear after 4 conscious movement up to 9 conscious movement, we call it prita ramana. And then if appear only after 10 to 15 conscious movement, it would be ati prita ramana. So by this we can differentiate these 4 sense objects. No, we differentiate in that way. So you have to take note, we have to use this. And then presentation of sense object at the mind door, only 2 ways you see. We buddha ramana mean clear presentation of sense objects. No, the sense object appear clearly in the mind door. And avidh buddha ramana, obscure presentation of sense objects. No, so that means not clear presentation of sense objects. So now the mind door is the mental door. No, the mind door. So mind door is the mind itself. No, so the mind is very very sensitive. So as soon as the sense object come in contact, it becomes it already appears. It appears just like we stand in front of the mirror. As soon as you stand in front of the mirror, you're No, your image appears in the mirror in the same way, no, for the mind door. So it does not take, no, the you see one moment, two moment, it doesn't take like that. No, immediately they will appear. Okay, now we, no, we go, we teach consciousness and we teach free consciousness. So those data which take part, no, participate, mean when they take part in the cognitive series of consciousness, they are called we teach consciousnesses, no, we teach data. And those data which do not participate in the cognitive series of consciousness, they are called we teach free consciousness. No, we teach, we muti. So, no, the yesterday we say only we teach, we mut, we say. So I have, I said, I told you, no, the, it, you have to add ti, we muti. Then it means we teach free, no, we teach free. So we teach free consciousnesses. And what are the we teach free consciousnesses? The 19 chaita, namely 2 upika sanina chaita, 8 mahavipaga chaita, and 9 mahakata vipaga chaita. No? So that perform as rebirth consciousness, life continuum, and death consciousness. No? So why they are performing these three functions? They do not appear in any sense though, and they don't take part in cognitive process. So, no, so we say they are not involved in the cognitive, no, the series. Why they are performing rebirth function, life continuum function, and then death function. So they are known as, no, viti, vimuti chaita. So viti is the cognitive, no, viti is cognitive process. So viti free consciousnesses. No, there are 19 viti free consciousnesses, and this chaita. Also called door-free consciousness. No, we have seen it in chapter 3. So remember these 19 consciousnesses? So please show chart number 5.1. Not yet, Aramana. Not Aramana Sangha. So it is 4.1 maybe, I think. Is not yet again. And 4.2. Okay, 4.2. So now this 4.2 is Kecha Sangha. So yesterday we say, no, the 14 function performed with various, no, consciousnesses, and then rebirth function, and then the, no, life continuum function and death function are performed this by 19 chaita. So they are 2 upika sanina chaita, 9 mahakata, no, vipaka chaita, and 8 mahavipaka chaita, and 9 mahakata vipaka chaita. So when they are performing this function, they don't arise in any sense though, and they don't take part, no, in the cognitive process. And then, no, we also said in 4.2 and 4.3. So we say also here, no, the dwara vimuti, door free. So those are those 19 chaita, no, 2 upekha sanina chaita, and 8 mahavipaka, and then 9 mahakata, no, we call them door-free, and now we call them also viti-free chaita. So, no, we get the viti-free chaita are 19. So they don't take part in the cognitive process. So of the above, no, 19 chaita, no, of these 19 chaita, the 2 upekha sanina chaita are involved in the cognitive series when they perform investigating function and registering function. And 8 mahavipaka chaita also take part, no, in the cognitive series when they perform as registering function. So these 10 chaita must be included in counting viti chaita. So since only the 9 mahakata vipaka chaita, no? Totally free from cognitive series. So the number of, no, the total number of vegetata in the sense sphere, no, in our sense sphere, is 89 minus 9, 80. So again, you show this function also, no? So when you ask, what are vegetative-free consciousnesses? You just answer, they are these 19 consciousnesses. When they are performing this function, no, they don't take part in any the cognitive or the consciousness process. But this, the two upika sanina chitta, no, they also perform, no, the sandhidana, investigating function, and then tadhalamana, registering function. So when they perform this function, they arise in the viti, in the cognitive series. And also the mahavipaka chitta, no? So instead of these three functions, it also performs. And remember, we say it should be here, no? This eight mahavipaka. So it also performs the jitting function. So they have to be counted among the cognitive series of consciousness. Only this nine mahavipaka chitta, it does not perform any other function. So they are always door-free and also always viti-free. Okay? Now we go to the next topic, three types of identical consciousness. So the life of a living being begins with a rebirth consciousness. No, begins with a rebirth consciousness. And after the dissolution of this rebirth consciousness, Bhavinga Chaita, we call life continuum, arise and perish continuously till dead, performing the function of life continuum. And the last Bhavinga Chaita is known as dead consciousness, no, because it performs dead function. For a living being, these three chaitas, namely rebirth consciousness, prasanthi chaita, and then life continuum, bhavinga chaita, and chuti chaita, dead consciousness, are the same in bat jati, in concomitant, that means the number of mental factors that associate with them, no, are the same, and also in the sense object, no, they take the same sense object, these three. So for normal human being, one of the eight mahavipaka chaita functions as patisanti chaita, bhavinga chaita, and chukti chaita. So these three functions are performed, no, by only one mahavipaka chaita. So for one person, no, your rebirth consciousness is only one of them. And that, no, that consciousness also perform, no, bhavinga chaita, the function and that function. These three chaita are identical in a person because they are the resultants of the same karma, no, associated with a mahakusala chaita. If the kusala chaita is somanasa sahagatam, jnana samyutam, asankarika mahakusala chaita, then somanasa sahagatam, jnana samyutam, asankarika mahavipaka chaita will function as rebirth consciousness, and then life continuum, and then dead consciousness. So these three chaita, they are the same mahavipaka chaita, no, identical chaita. Okay. No, so if you look at the chaita chart number one, no, chart number one. So now we say this eight mahavipaka chaita, no, they are the result then of this eight mahakusala chaita. So if you perform the meritorious deed with number one, no, the mahakusala chaita, that we give the name here. So when it, no, when the karma that arises from this chaita, when it produces its result then, so it also produces number one mahavipaka chaita. Now we call them the same name, somanasa sagatam, jnana sambhutam, asankarika mahavipaka chaita. No? So that would be the rebirth consciousness, life continuum and death consciousness. Okay, so we can go to the next topic again. So they say near death sign, no? Marana sanna namita. So yesterday I told you when a person is about to die, no? So this near death sign will always appear. Will always appear. You just watch a person about to die, no? So you can see. So now if the person dies very peacefully, we say he is having got near death sign. So if he becomes frightened like that, then it's not good, not good. So he might be seeing the hell, no, something like that. So he becomes frightened. So that is not a good sign. So when he dies, he will be born in the hell. No? Okay, let's read together. In the present life, a person will be alive as long as the kusala karma, which has given him rebirth in this life, keeps on supporting him, that is, keep on producing bhavinga chitta life continuum and karma-born materiality as karma resultant. Just before that supporting karma fades out, the many kusala karmas and akusala karmas in the mental stream compete with one another to have the chance of bearing karma result. And one karma will emerge as the winner. This successful karma may appear in the mind door of the person as karma object. No, as karma, karma will appear as the near-death object, near-death sign. No? And then when this happens, the person may remember the good or bad action which he has performed in the past in connection with this successful karma. No? So the moral in moral consciousness experience at that particular moment arises now as a fresh consciousness. In other words, it is a recurring of the consciousness which one has experienced in performing the action. Now you are listening to the Abhidhamma, so no, the moral minds are arising in you. No, moral minds are arising in you. So again, if it is the number one, say, no, the moral mind, no, arise in you, and if this karma, no, this karma, they arise in you now, one of the karma, the jeta, will have the chance to bear result. No? So at that time, that when this karma appears in the mind door, no? So you will remember the consciousness, the same consciousness. The same consciousness, it will be the similar consciousness, we might say, no? Will arise in you. So when that sign arises, oh, I remember Dr. Monser teaching. So you can do like that. So we say that's why it is like recurring of that, not that the consciousness in you. But at times, it may be a sign or symbol associated with that successful karma that appears at one of the sense door. It may be one of the five physical objects view through one of the five doors as a present object, or view through the mind door as a past object. This past or present object in connection with the successful karma is called karma nimitta, the sign of karma. So as I said, no, that karma arises in you to get, you get the, no, the similar, the same consciousness, and that when that arises, you remember this Abhidhamma teaching. Then, no, so sometimes that does not appear, but you can see the sign, just you see now. So Dr. Mendemon standing in front of the chart and pointing the chart and teaching us. So that will be, so we call that sign of karma, not sign of karma. So if you, you pay homage to the Buddha, downstairs, and then if that karma, has a chance to bear result. So, the chaita that way you pay respect, the Buddha. So what would be that chaita? So one of the eight, Mahakusala chaita again. So whatever it is, number one or two, if it is number one again, then the same type of, the number one moral consciousness will arise in you, that when the karma appear in you. And sometimes you don't, it is not distinct, the karma is not distinct. And the Buddha statue becomes not distinct to you. And we call that the sign of karma again. And remember, if it's the past sign, so the previous sign you have seen it. So the past sign cannot appear in the eye door. Only present sign can appear in the five door. So if it is the past sign, it will appear in the mind door. And if it is the present sign, it can appear in the eye, in the ear, in the nose. So we also explain here. And then in another case, we say, so we are here now. For example, let us suppose that a person listens to the Dhamma at the dying moment, and this good karma of listening to the Dhamma, that Dhamma, becomes successful karma to bear karma result for his next life. In this case, that present audible Dhamma words, grasps through the ear, becomes the karma nimitta. So now it is the present object now. So you are hearing that Dhamma, that is Dhamma voice, and while you are listening to it, you get that near that sign arising. So in that case, that sign, the voice, the present voice, the present sound that you are hearing, become the sign of the karma sign of the meter, sign of karma. And then again, in another case, let us suppose that a dying teacher sees through his mental eye, mano vijnana, the student she has taught, and this is past sense object, remember? So it will be it is also karma nimitta. We call it the sign of karma, karma nimitta, in the form of a past object, and which appears at the mind door. So you should know the difference. Or say, in another case, a dying butcher hears the groans of the cattle he has killed. So this past audible object is also karma nimitta So presented to him through the mind door. It is past sense object again. At times, some symbol of the place in which he is to be reborn, according to the successful karma, may appear at the mind door. For example, celestial being, celestial mansion, etc., may appear to the dying person if he is to be reborn in one of the celestial realms. Or miserable people in hell or hellhound, etc., may appear to him if he is to be born in hell. So these signs we call sign of destiny. Sign of destiny, gati namida. The destiny is the place where he's going to be born. So the sign connected with it. So if you see the celestial being, celestial mansion, well, you may die very smilingly because you will be born in celestial realm. So if you see the light of the hell, the hell denizen and hell dogs, etc., so you become scared at that time. You become scared. So that shows that you are going to be born in hell. And then his pati sandhi chaita, buhinga chaita, and chuti chaita in the new life will all grasp near that sign of that that past life. So we don't show the sign when you are going to be reborn in the human realm. So usually when you are going to be reborn in the human realm, no, they say you saw the womb of the mother as a red velvet, red velvet, they say. No, so if you can see like that, you are going to be born in human realm. Or if you see human houses and human being, that also that show that you are going to be born in a human realm. No? So the sign of the destiny is like the present sign. So they can appear in any of the six senses. And the appearance of these three types of near-death sign, namely kama, kama nimitta, kadi nimitta, and the rebirth consciousness, life continuum and death consciousness, constitute three modes of vijja-bhavati for vimutti-citta. So actually when one of the signs appears, then we have a cognitive series. No, a cognitive series will arise. And only after that cognitive series, the person will die. So, no, in this cognitive series, no, there are only five jhāvana citta, not seven jhāvana citta. No, because when you are about to die, all the material basis become very weak. So only five, the jhāvana citta, because marana sanna jhāvana citta will arise. And then soon after that you die, and so after that consciousness, rebirth consciousness, the new existence arises. And it will take that near-death sign. Now this the rebirth consciousness, it will take the near-death sign, no, that is observed by the near-death, no, the marana sanna jhāvana citta. So it will take that sign. And then that sign is transmitted to the next consciousness, we call Bhuvinga Chaita. So all Bhuvinga Chaita also take only that sign. And then finally the dead consciousness also take that near that sign. So, and we see the appearing of these three signs, the Kama sign or Kama Namita or Green Namita. No, at the rebirth consciousness, life continuum and death consciousness constitute three modes of vijja-bhavati, presentation of sense object at the sense door. So we also call it three modes of vijja-bhavati. So earlier we say there are six types of vijja-bhavati. Just now we finished. No, four at the mind, at the five senses, and two at the mind door. We have it, six. All right. So if you ask, when I appear for the examination, the question is, describe the nine vijja-bhavati. You see the nine forms of vijja-bhavati. So I have looked only that six are the six types. Six types of bhavati that we have seen earlier. So I said, it's only in the book they mention only six types. Why they are asking the nine types? Maybe there is a mistake in the question paper. Well, and then I also made thinking again. Oh, if it's a mistake, so the person who are on duty for this examination, they will announce it makes a mistake. Now is it doesn't announce, so the question must be correct. I said, so I knew only six, so I just answer this six first, and then I leave the space and I answer another thing. So only after finishing, I try to think what can be the three things. And finally, I can remember that, near that sign, they can appear in the door also, in the mind door or in any of the six door. So that is also mean three types of presentation of sense object. So when I can, then I can answer these three also. Well, it would be correct because I stood first in the whole in the whole country. Well, not only one time. Not only one time. So the next year I have to go to the Australia, not to have the further research study in the University of New South Wales. So when I came back the next year, I appeared for the honors level Abhidhamma. So at that time, actually, while I'm teaching in the university, I take only 1 month. No? If you know this, the essence of Buddha Abhidhamma, you can understand all the Buddha's teaching. So the higher Abhidhamma, you can understand. So just I study by myself for 1 month and appear for the examination. So again, I got this gold medal. Gold medal to attend, again, standing first in the whole Myanmar. And the next year again, I appear for the Visuddhi Magga examination. 3 books, very big books, about six, in the price of prescribed book, 600 pages. Not the big book, 600 pages. I take 3 months, only 3 months. No? So one book, 1 month. So I read it, try to take it by myself. And then appear for the examination. So another gold medal again. Wow. And not only that. So while I attend the Yangon University, so for studying to get BSc degree and BSc honors degrees. So I also got 3 gold medals. Wow. And not only that. Where to study in the United States? No? So the first month I have a lot of trouble. No, because what I said, they don't know. I thought they said, I don't know. So when I go to the shop to buy something to eat, I want this. So I have to point like that. But it takes only 1 month. So after 1 month, I understand them, they understand me. So in the first year, I worked very hard actually. No, so not only, if we can attain 8 units, so they will give you the master degree. But I attained 10 units. Wow. Not only that, because when we are going to for doctorate degree, we have to study 2 foreign languages, besides English. So I take the German language as a course. And then I appear for the French language. By appearing after studying, just appear for the examination. I passed 2 of them. So in 1 year, so I get, So I don't want to request for the master degree. If you have 8 unit only, you have to apply for master degree. But now, I also conducted research, and then I can write a thesis. So when you can write master thesis, so they have to they give you the master degree. So in 1 year, so I can I finish. So 10 units plus 2 languages. So no American student can do that, actually. So I was amazed. A letter came from the university office. So they said, you are awarded university fellowship. Very high, very so. Don't they give only to the top student, 1 or 2 of the top student. So I also got 1. So the next 2 years, I got for 2 years. So they allow me to attend the university. So all the tuition fees, the fees to the university, so they make me free. And beside that, they gave me also $1,750 each year. $3,500 for 2 years, so I can buy a car and come home. Well, if you try hard, you can do that, you can achieve that. Okay, so what is the next one? Three types of Bhunga Chaita. So now we'll see that later, and we go to the next topic. The next topic. So this is no cognitive series. Now the cognitive series come now. So cognitive series at the eye door. And number one is the occurrence of Ati Mahanda Ramana. No, very great intensity, no sense object appearing at the eye door. No, viti. When a visible object of very great intensity strikes the eye door, so Ati Mahanda Ramana, no Ati Mahanda Ramana viti, no cognitive series arises. So the cognitive series may be represented by the following symbols. No? So I think you can show chart number, no? That 4.2, I think, no? 4.2. Where we okay, this chart. So remember, no, when the cognitive series arise, they will perform for the 11 function, no, except these three. No, so the rebirth, and then the Bhunga Chaita, and then Bhunga function, rebirth function, and death function are not included, no, in the cognitive process. Only these 11, no, they are included. So we begin in this series. So we begin with Avachana. Avachana is performed for the five sense door, Panja Dwara Vachana. So now we get here Panja Dwara Vachana. And then after that, now what is the next function? So now after you get the Avachana, so now this Panja Vinyana Thana we call, now five functions are included here. So it is in the eye door, you have the seeing function, no, the dasana kicca. So it is the seeing function is performed by eye consciousness. So we say, no, chakhu vijnana. And after that, you have to go to the next, no, the function. So it is receiving function, sambadechana. So you can see sambadechana. And then, no, you go to the next function, sandirana. So this na and na, no, actually they have the, no, the different. We have a dot here, no, a dot here, this na, no, the N is a dot here. So sandhirana, and under sandhirana you get vottapana and jhamana. So the same thing, vottapana and the jhamana chaita arises seven times. And then the dalamana, no, the dalamana arises two times. No, so these are cognitive process. So, no, before the cognitive consciousness can arise, no, the Bhunga stream must be cut off. No, so, before we see any sense object appear in the eye door, only Bhunga Chitta will be arising. No, will be arising. So, no, at this Tinada, they are also Bhunga Chitta. No, Bhunga Chitta, they are. So at the arising moment of this, no, we call it Atita Bhunga. So these three cycles, they show this is the arising moment, this is existing moment, and then this is perishing moment. So at the arising moment of this, no, Bhunga Chaita, so sense objects comes in contact with the eye sense door. So the eye sense door is chakupasada. So chakupasada and the sense object, visible object, they arise together at the arising moment of this Atita Bhunga. Atita Bhunga means the past, the life continuum. So when another sense object, it appears at the arising movement of this atita bhuenga, after one conscious movement, that is one chitta, no, when it passed by, then it arises, the sense object appears at the sense door. So here we say, the sense object appears at the sense door. So when the sense appears, no, this dipta bhuenga start vibrating. And we call it vibrating bhuenga, bhuenga chalana. So we put it na. And this is, we call it ti. No? Atita bhuenga means the past life continuum. So, no, after the sense object strikes the eye door, before it appears, so this one, only one bhuenga chitta pass by. So we call it atita bhuenga. And at that time, when the sense object appears, so in order to take notice of this sense object, no, bhuenga chitta must not cut off. It's the, we say, oh, bhuenga chitta, no, they take the near-death sign, remember? So no, they have to, no, to release the near-death sign and you take the new sign. So in some way, it has, no, the, it vibrates something. And then it vibrates two times, no, not da. And when this second vibrating the consciousness, no, the dissolve, and also the life continuum is cut off. So we call it bhuengupachida, no, bhuengupachida. So the name of ti is atita bhuenga. We call past life, no, past bhuenga, not ti atita bhuenga. And then this one is, no, bhuenga chalana. So no, this is bhuenga chalana, vibrating life continuum. So when we come to the, no, the second bhuenga chalana, we call it bhuengupachida. So bhuengu, G-U. So no, bhuengu upachida. So bhuenga chitta plus upachida. Upachida means cut off or arrested. So we call it arrested life continuum or cut off life continuum. So after, no, this bhuenga pachida, the bhuenga stream is cut off. Then only, no, we say cognitive series starts with panca dvara vajana, cakku vijnana, samparichana, etc. So we give you the description here. At first, no, so this one, bhuenga, no, bhuenga is life continuum. At first, there is a stream of life continuum. Only bhuenga chitta will be, no, arising and flowing, no, when we don't know any sense object. So only bhuenga chitta will be arising. Now the three small cycles, no, they represent three sub-movements that make up a conscious movement. No, one conscious movement is equal to three sub-movements. So now we get this atita bhuenga. Atita bhuenga is the past bhuenga. So at the arising moment of this atita bhuenga, the visible object and the cakkhupasada, the idol, no, the sense object and the idol, they arise simultaneously. And this is the arising moment, upada, of the visible object. No, so at the arising moment of the atita bhuenga, so no, the sense object also arises. And then na bhuenga chalana, vibrating life continuum. So at the rising moment of this chitta, no, the bhuenga chalana, the visible object appears, no, becomes distinct at the eye door. Note that ati mahanta ramana takes one conscious moment for its full development after striking the sense door. So, no, after we have to allow for one conscious moment, no, for the sense object to become distinct. And then that is bhuengupachida, arrested or cut off, no, life continuum. Bhuenga stream is cut off after, no, the dissolution of this, no, consciousness. So this is, we call three types of bhuenga chitta. No? So if you can go just above this, above, okay, above this, I think, before this. Okay, you go down. So you have to go to the back page. The back page maybe. Okay, after this, we have three, you know, the, no. Here. No, these are three bhuinga. So you just take note it from here. Atida bhuinga mean those bhuinga chaitas, which pass by from the time the sense object strikes the sense door to the time the sense object appears at the door. No, the pass by bhuinga chaita. No, we call atida bhuinga. And bhuinga chalana means vibrating bhuinga, which arises when the sense object appears at the sense door. And then, no, we have bhuinga pachida, cut off, no, bhuinga, that follows the bhuinga chalana. And after this, no, after this consciousness, the bhuinga stream is cut off, and the cognitive series, vichicheta, starts arising. So now this is the three types of bhuinga chaita. No, so if you are asked in the examination, so you just write down write only this much. That's all right. No? You will get 4 marks. No? Okay. Now we go on with the cognitive series. We finish only three yet. No? So now we come to the. No, the we start with Panca Dwara Vajana. Pa, no, stands for Panca Dwara Vajana. So we call it five door directing consciousness. It is always the first, no, chaita, this Panca Dwara Vajana, in the cognitive series of Panca Dwara. No, we take no, five door cognitive the series. It is always the first, not the first consciousness to take notice of the sense object that appears in the sense door. So it confronts, no, or it apprehends, or it takes notice the sense object and directs the consciousness stream towards the sense object. So that is Panca Dwara Vajana. And it is followed by Chakhu Vijnana, eye consciousness. And now this eye consciousness sees the visible object, not just for one conscious movement, not just very short time, and transmits, not that object to the next consciousness before it perishes. So now we are told that only eye consciousness can be aware of visible object. Other consciousnesses cannot be aware of visible object. No, so we say after eye consciousness sees the object, it must transmit it not to the next consciousness, so that the next consciousness also know not the sense object. So the next consciousness is Sambarichana Chaita. No, Samarichana Chaita, receiving consciousness. It just receives the sense object, and again it relays that sense object to the next consciousness. And the next consciousness is Sandirana, investigating consciousness. It investigates the object whether it is good or bad. Again, no, it relays the sense object to the next, so it is Vottabana. Now, Vottabana is determination, we say. So it is performed by Mano Dwara Vachana. So it determines, no, so we call it determining consciousness. It determines whether the sense object is good or bad. It decides. No? And then Jhamana. No? Jhamana Chaita are called impulsive consciousness. Not sense seven, no? It arises seven times. No? Very quickly, so we call them impulsive consciousness. They are the consciousness that enjoy the taste of the sense object. No? So remember, there are 29 kama jhamana chaita. So though no, there are 29 kama jhamana chaita at one time, only one jhamana chaita must arise. No? Chaita can arise only one at a time, no? Not two at a time. No? So, for example, no, when we in the kama jhamana chaita, so we have cuckoo clock, remember? Cuckoo creek, cuckoo creek. So cuckoo means 12 immoral mind, akusala chaita, 8 mahakusala chaita, and then 8 mahakriya chaita. No, and then also we have Hasitupada, remember? No, so 29 of them, one of them only. So if the determination, what tapana, if it determines a sense object, to be very beautiful and desirable, then lopa mula jeda warais. No? So it say, I don't like it, no, I hate it, dosa mula jeda warais. So we say, it is a Buddha setu, very venerable, then kusala cheda warais. No? So one of the javana cheda warais at one time, not javana. And they arise seven times, and we also know the sense object only at when the javana cheda arises. And we think that we enjoy the sense object. No? Because the chitta is part of ourselves. So when the consciousness enjoys the taste of sense object, we think we enjoy it. No? Actually, we do not exist. So you should know that. No? And then we are after that, so the dhalabana, no, registering function, consciousness. Though we use the name the registering, no, other translator, no, so ahead of me, in front of me, they have used this word, so I also use this word. No, actually, it does not make any registration. It does not make any registration. No, so it only denotes that the final cognitive consciousness. After this, the cognitive series will end. We end. We come to an end. No, we come to a close, and maybe because of that. So its function is it. No. It also continues to enjoy the taste of the sense object. That is its function, not the dhalamana. So it immediately follows javana and runs for two consciousness moment. So that means two dhalamana chitta will arise, also enjoying the taste of the sense object. At the dissolving moment of the second dhalamana chitta, the visible object and the chakku prasada also dissolve together because their lifespan of 17 conscious moments is now complete. So if you count like this, so this cognitive series, no, we have to go back. So this one, correct. So we say the sense object arise, no, at the rising moment of this atida bhinga. No? So also sense object arises here. So when this sense object disappears, now perishes, it gets one conscious moment. And then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 conscious moments. So now their lifespan, the visible object and the idol, chakku prasada, they arise together. So not both of them now perish together. So dissolve means they perish. So as no sense object remain, so the bhinga chaita will keep flowing again. No, this bhinga chaita. So when we don't know any sense object, bhinga chaita will keep arising. No, will keep arising. Okay. No? So now we get after death, we have bhinga, life continuum. Since the visible object no longer exists, the cognitive series ends, no, comes to an end. And the consciousness stream sinks into life continuum. So when we say like that, no, the consciousness stream keep on flowing with life continuum consciousnesses. So sing so that they become, not sing and then do life continuum. When we get cognitive consciousness, they are functioning, it seems that it is they have been intensity. So and then it sings to life continuum. So we use this word. Or you can say, not life, and then after that, life continuum keep flowing. You can say like that, no? Keep arising or keep flowing. So note, the Ati Mahanta Ramana Viti is also known as Tada Lambana. Remember, the La Ramana and the Da Lambana, they have the same meaning. No, dada lambana vara viti. So it means it terminates with dada lambana citta. No, it is that it is so when it no it so here no it finished with the dalamana, so we call them the dalamana vara viti. So now this cognitive series finished now. So I think you all understand. So I can say sadhu, sadhu, sadhu. So if you understand it, so the subsequent, no, the cognitive series would be almost similar, no, you can understand easily. So we go to the second cognitive series, number two, the occurrence of Mahanda Ramana Viti. So no, this one is Ati Mahanda, here is Mahanda, so the sense object is only fairly great intensity. So again, just like before, no, it strikes the idol. No, so at the moment of the first Atida Bhinga, no, at the rising moment of the first Atida Bhinga. Here we have two Atida Bhinga because no, the intensity is no, the weaker than the Ati Mahanda. So it takes longer time. No, it takes longer time to develop itself, no, the sense object. To develop the sense object to become distinct. So here we have only one T, here we have two T. So at the rising moment of the first Atita Bhinga, again just like before, we say the sense object and the I door, they arise together. And now the sense object become distinct only after two conscious moments. So two consciousness pass by before the sense object become distinct. So we have two Atita Bhinga. And just like before, now when the sense object appear, so the Bhinga Chitta start vibrating. Now it vibrates two times, Bhinga Chalana, Bhingupa Chitta. And after the two vibration, so the Bhinga stream is cut off, now after Bhingupa Chitta. Then Viti Chaita arise just like before. Panja Dwaravajana, Chaku Vinyana, Samrishana, Sandhyana, Vodhapana, and seven Jhavana. Now, after seven Jhavana, if you count the Chaita, no, so from here, the sense object appears here, remember? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 16. No, altogether 16. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So when you get to the Jhavana, no, already 16 conscious moments pass by. So no, the lifespan of materiality, visible object, no, only one conscious moment left. No, only one subconscious. Remember, their lifespan is 17. Conscious moment, now already 16 conscious moment already passed by, so only one conscious moment is left. So two Dada Lamana Chitta cannot arise. The Dada Lamana always arise two times, no? So if it cannot arise two times, the Dada Lamana do not arise at all. So we just take note that the Dada Lamana arise only when the sense object is very distinct. No, if it's fairly distinct, the Dalamana do not arise anymore. So, no, when the Dalamana cannot arise, we just put in Bhinga Chitta. That means Bhinga Chitta will arise. So that means, no, so after this, the cognitive series finish. So when Bhinga Chitta arise, it means already finished. So when the first Bhinga Chitta, no, the after the Javana arise, so the sense object also perish at when this first Bhinga perish. And after that, only Bhinga Chitta will keep arising. No? So we give you here, no, the explanation. So you can read now. In the first Mahanda Ramana Viti, the sense object and the Chakupasada idol arise together at the arising moment of the first Atita Bhinga. No, first Atita Bhinga. the sense object takes two consciousness moments, not TT, two conscious moments, for its full development, and it becomes distinct at the idol, at the arising moment of Povinga Chalana. So when na, no, when you get na, so that means no, the sense object appears. So to know that sense object, so now the Povinga stream vibrates two times and cut off. So the way we explain like this is, remember this citta, they arise and perish very rapidly. No, even in one moment, 1,000 billion, very fast. Now if a man not running very fast, so if it comes in front of you, you ask him, now you stop. Can he stop immediately? So now it would take about the 20 steps, only then he can stop. So this the consciousness stream also, as they are rising very quickly, now the sense object appears. You must take notice of this sense object. So that means you must stop now. So it cannot stop immediately. So it takes two conscious moments. So that the nada vibrates two times and cut off. So only then, to know the pancha dvara vajana will take notice of that sense object, and then chakku vijnana will see that sense object, samrechana receives it, sandirana investigate it, uttavana determine it, and then after determination we have seven jhavana, enjoying the taste of the sense object, and after that the dhalamana cannot arise. So Buinga Chitta arise. So that means cognitive series comes to an end. Okay? So now we go to the can we go here or what? Now we say, so after the 11 conscious movement, that we have counted. So we say the idol and the sense object, they perish together, they arise together, and they perish together. So the cognitive series terminates, and life continuum proceeds as usual of the dead. Thus, there are two Mahanta Ramana we teach in this case, which end with the Jhavana Chitta. So now we say, that cognitive series, they come to an end with Jhavana Chitta, and we don't count Buinga Chitta in the cognitive series. So only the cognitive consciousness. So we say it terminates with Jhavana Chitta, and so they are known as Jhavana Vara Viti. Remember the first one ends with the Dhalamana, we call it the Dhalamana Vara Viti. Now it is called Jhavana Vara Viti. Now in number three, the occurrence of Preta Ramana Viti. So Preta Ramana means slight, sense object of slight intensity. So when a visible object of slight intensity strikes the eye door again, so now remember, just like before, this sense object and the eye door, they arise together at the arising moment of the first Atita Buinga. Now, as a sense object is of slight intensity, so it takes 4 to 9 consciousness moment to become distinct, to develop itself, to become distinct. So in the number two, we have 3 Atita Buinga. Now we have 4 Atita Buinga, 4 Atita Buinga. And only after that, the sense object appears, and then Buinga Chalana arises, vibrates two times, so it is cut off of the Buingu Pachida. And then cognitive series begins again, just as before. We begin with Pancha Dwara Vajana, apprehending the sense object. Chakku Vinyana sees it, and then Samrichana No, Samarijana receives the sense object, and then Sandirana investigate it, and Vottabana determining it. Now, up to this, no, when come to the determination, how many conscious moment pass by? So we can count again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. So, no, 11 conscious movement all already passed by. So, how many conscious movement left? No, for the life of the whisper object. So, only six, no, the six conscious movement is left. So now, if there are only six conscious movement, so you know, the Javana Chitta cannot arise seven times. And again, no, normally Javana Chitta arises seven times. So if it cannot arise seven times, then we say it does not arise at all again. No, it does not arise at all. So, and another fact is that as the sense object is, you know, the very slight intensity, this Vottabana. So remember, Vottabana perform two function. No, the one function is apprehending the sense object, and then second function is, no, determines it. Remember here, no, we have the, no, the Vottabana. Where is the Vottabana? No. Chart number 4.2. No, so here, so we have, no, the Manodwara Vachana is performing Vottabana function. So it also performs the Avachana, apprehending function. And then it performs, no, the Vottabana function. It performs two functions. So now we say it takes notice, no, or apprehend the sense object. No, present the sense object, and then try to decide it. As the sense object is of very slight intensity, so it is not distinct. It is not distinct. You can, no? So it is known, it is not known clearly, and it is not very distinct. So Vottabana cannot decide whether it is good or bad. It cannot decide. If you can, no, Vottabana cannot decide, no, whether the sense object is good or bad, then, no, Javana Chaita cannot arise to enjoy the sense object, the taste of the sense object. No, as the sense object is not well known and cannot be decided whether it's good or bad, so that is another reason, no, that show that, no, the wing of the Javana Chaita cannot arise. So, no, we have two factors. One is the lifespan of consciousness, no, is left only for six conscious moments. And Javana always arise seven times, so it cannot arise seven times, so it doesn't arise. And another point we say, as, no, the sense object is not known clearly, and Vottabana cannot decide whether it's good or bad, so Javana Chitta do not arise to enjoy that sense object. So when Javana Chitta cannot arise, Vottabana arises two more times, no, in place of the Javana Chitta. And again, no, it apprehends the sense object and decide. Cannot decide again. And another time, apprehend the sense object and decide again. Cannot decide. So, no, so only after that, Bhuvanga Chitta keep arising. So that means, no, the cognitive series, no, terminates with this Vottabana. So after that, no, so the lifespan, no, left six and conscious movement is left, we say, after this. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Where? So after this one, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, no, after two Vottabana, we just put in four Buddha Chitta, no, to show determination of, no, the sense object. So when this fourth Buddha Chitta perishes, the sense object and the eye door, no, they arise together here, they also perish together. So after that, also Buddha Chitta will keep arising. So we get this, no, the cognitive series, and we can write, no, five more series for, you know, for this Pratyaramana, no, the presentation of sense object. So we say, no, if the sense object is weaker, so it will take, no, one more, no, conscious moment to be, no, for the sense object to become distinct. So here is four adhita bhinga, here we put five adhita bhinga. When you increase one adhita bhinga in the front, you reduce one bhinga chaita, no, in the rear. Because all the chaita will have only 17, no, word of a sense, only 17 conscious moment, no, the lifespan of consciousness, the lifespan of visible object. And then we can also, no, write the other cognitive series. So by increasing one atida bhinga in the front and reducing one bhinga at the rear, so now when he comes here, only one bhinga left. And here, so no bhinga left, only it terminates with the vottapana. And then in the sixth viti, no, we have to cut off one vottapana. No, because only 17 conscious moment, only, you know, is allowed. So we have only two vottapana here. No, and then we cannot reduce anymore. No, so the reason is when the jhamana chitta do not arise to enjoy the sense of object, and the vottapana, no, arises in place of the jhamana chitta, we say it must arise at least two times. So now only, no, we have to stop here. So, no, after this, this cognitive series, no, terminates. So we write here six, no, so the cognitive series. All of them, we say they terminate with vottapana. No, we don't count the bhinga chitta, no, as the cognitive consciousness. So you just, no, the omit them. So we say they terminate with vottapana. So they are called vottapana vara viti. Okay. No, so we have explanation. What explain do you hear? So no, written here, so we can read again. In the first Pratyaramana viti, the sense object and the chakhu prasada, the eye door, they arise together at the arising moment of the first atida bhinga. The sense object takes four conscious moment for its full development, and it becomes distinct at the rising moment of bhinga jalana, that is, you know, with this symbol. And after that, the life continuum, bhinga stream, vibrates two times or twice, and becomes arrested or cut off. So we call nada, not vibrating two times. Then the cognitive series proceeds in the order of pancha dwara vachana, chakhu vijana, sambarechana, sandirana, vottapana. No, so at the first vottapana, at this point we say 11 consciousness, no, consciousness moment have elapsed or have passed by since the genesis, the arising of the sense object. And the sense object and the eye door, no, it should be the sense object, and the sense object can last only for six more consciousness moment. So in normal situation, the jhamana usually occurs for seven consciousness moment, and if there is no enough time, it does not occur at all. So in other words, as the object is not distinct and not known precisely, no jhamana arises to enjoy the taste of the sense object. So two more vottapana chitta arise in place of jhamana to determine, no? So to determine whether whether the object is good or bad. After that, the consciousness stream sinks into life continuum. So that means after that only life continuum keep arising. Now keep flowing, you can say. And the sense object and the idol, now they dissolve or perish at the perishing movement of the fourth bhavanga chitta. And life continuum flows on as usual of the dead. Now of the dead, only life continuum keep flowing. So we also write five more viti, and we give this statement here for the subsequent five viti. In the next five successive viti cognitive series, atida bhuinga, t is increased one by one as the object becomes weaker and weaker. And accordingly, the chaitas in the ray have to be cut off one by one as the total consciousness movement cannot exceed the lifespan, that is 17 conscious movement of the sense object. Thus, at the sixth cognitive series, the cognitive series terminates after two vatthapana chaita. So the number of vatthapana chaita cannot be reduced further, as there must be at least two vatthapana chaita in functioning in place of jhavana. So there are six pratyaramana viti, which all end with vatthapana, so they are known as vatthapana vara viti. As there are no jhavanas in these vitis, there is no enjoyment of the taste of the sense object. The object is not precisely known, and it seems to be known very roughly. So these vitis occur when sense objects are not distinct, or in babies whose eye bases are weak. So even when the sense object is of great intensity, so its appearance is not distinct. So this type of viti also arises in babies. So when the sense object is very far, we cannot see very clearly, so this type of viti also arises. No? So now we come to the food. Thank you very much. Even 15 minutes passed by, okay. So we take 15 minutes as usual. So just enjoy, enjoy the break.